just wanna praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory. Just wanna praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory and honor, they thank you, Jesus, for blessing me. I just wanna praise you forever and ever and ever for all you've done for me. Blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to you. Thank you, Jesus, for blessing me. Just wanna praise you for blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to you. Blessings and glory and honor, they all belong to you. Blessings and glory and honor.
Today we gather for the 29th Sunday in the ordinary time, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
With your spirit.
Let us put ourselves before God's mercy. Lord Jesus, you come to heal our broken hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to give forgiveness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you come to guide us by the power of your spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve you with sincerity of heart. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have grasped, to subdue nations before him and strip kings of their robes, to open doors before him, and the gates shall not be closed. For the sake of my servant Jacob and Israel my chosen, I call you by your name, I surname you. Though you do not know me, I am the Lord, and there is no other. Besides me there is no God. I arm you, though you do not know me, so that all may know, from the rising of the sun and from the west, that there is no one beside me. I am the Lord, and there is no other. My brothers and sisters, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will extol you, O my God and King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all, and compassionate towards all his works. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. The Lord is faithful in all his words, and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are falling, and raises up all who are bowed down. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God. I will praise your name forever, my King and my God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. From Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy, to the Church of the Thessalonians. In God the Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We always give thanks to God for all of you and mention you in our prayers, constantly remembering before our God and Father your work of faith and labor of love and steadfast of hope in our Lord Jesus Christ. For we know, brothers and sisters, beloved by God, that he has chosen you, because our message of the gospel came to you not in word only, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, and with full conviction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory.
The Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. And so they sent their disciple to him, along with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere, and you teach the way of God in accordance with truth, and show deference to no one, for you do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then what you think. Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" But Jesus, aware of their malice, "Why are you putting me to the test, you hypocrites? Show me the coin used for tax." And they brought him a denarius. Then he said to them, "Whose head is on this and whose title?" They answered, "Caesar." Then he said to them, "Give therefore to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's." My brothers and sisters, our salvation, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As you might notice, I have something new to wear today. This is some kind of nut lei from Hawaii. I just came back from my birthday celebration. My 75th birthday was celebrated somewhere in the middle of the Pacific. Thank you. So somewhere in the middle of the Pacific between California and Hawaii, we celebrated my birthday, which is wonderful. Just the fact to be God's beauty and away from all the noise and chaos of D.C. is wonderful. So when we got to Hawaii, our hotel was literally across the street from St. Augustine by the Sea Catholic Church. And I noticed that the pastor there had on like a lei. It was probably one something like this. And so did all the ushers, both men and women ushers. I thought, oh, this is cool. So that's why I brought one back for Deacon Bobby and myself to wear for a while to celebrate that at least one of us got to go to Hawaii. And no, God of surprises. So today, as we celebrate, let me explain that. The whole custom of the flower lays or bead lays in Hawaii is one of welcome. Like, we actually went to a luau one evening, and they gave us all one of those flower lays. And they said, aloha, welcome. And so this means a sign of welcome. Just like here at St. Martin's, we have a big sign out in front of our church that says, welcome all sinners. Well, to be able to welcome people here to St. Martin's, we have to also have something to give. We have to have the resources to do that. And part of doing the resources, what we heard in the very last line of the gospel today, was give to Caesar what's Caesar's and give to God what is God's. Well, part of the giving to God or God's community is about our own stewardship and how we use our resources. For the last 3 or 4 or 5 weeks, we've talked about time and talent. We've talked about people to use their gifts to be lectors and Eucharistic ministers and ushers to join the choir. In fact, today's reader, the new reader, Kate Toth, was one of the new people we recruited. So Kate, we're really happy to have you with us. This is the first time she's been with us on the YouTube Mass. So for those of you who only see us as part of the YouTube Mass, that's why Kate is one of the new folks here at St. Martin's who was chosen to share her gifts. So today I want to tell, okay guys, I'm working on what do they call that? Jet lag, that's what it is. It's a 6-hour difference between Hawaii and here. And I left Hawaii 36 hours ago. So I'm doing right well to figure out I'm in church right now. So it's a challenge. I'll leave it at that. So time, treasure, talent. Treasure is what I want to talk about. Stewardship in the sense of using our financial resources to continue to support the ministries here at St. Martin's. The reason the St. Martin's works the way it works is a whole lot of people share their time, their treasure, and their talent. And I invite those of you who have yet to choose to make a commitment financially to St. Martin's to do so. Stewardship is something that's very important in lots of ways to make the church run. If without money, we can't pay our bills. And just, for example, the PepsiCo bill, for some reason, is like almost twice what it used to be. I don't know why that is. If it's everybody else, I think I've talked to many of my parishioners who said the same thing. So I guess they got to raise the rate. But we have to keep things going here. All of us are invited to use our treasures in different ways. I remember when I first came to St. Augustine back now, it had to be 40-some years ago. I had been there like literally 1 week when Father Mudd says to me, hey, Mike, here's your new envelopes. I said, envelopes? What do I need envelopes for? I thought the deal was the people give us money and we spend it. He says, no, we don't do that here. We all give the money and we collectively, as the church leadership, figure out how to spend it. Really? So I had envelopes there. I have envelopes here at St. Martin's. I spend, of my income I get each month, I give 5% back to the church. I give 5% to other charities. So basically, I use envelopes and I put $30 in the envelope each week. Actually, I write a check once a month, but it's easier for me. But that's my commitment. And I know you can give these days many ways. You can use the old envelope system. We'll be happy to mail those. It usually takes 6 to 8 weeks after you give us your name. You can do the more speedy process and do e-giving. You can do it through PayPal, Perisoft giving. In fact, now about 35% of all people who give to support St. Martin's do so online, which is wonderful. You give the money and we get it right away. Thank God for computers and all this internet stuff. But however people choose to give, it's how we continue to take care of all of our ministries, not just the utilities and stuff, but how we do a lot of our outreach. In fact, I was talking to our finance council a couple months ago, and we realized that here at St. Martin's, we use 34% of our total income for a year on outreach. And outreach includes our food pantry, it includes emergency assistance for families in need, it includes what we're getting ready to do at Thanksgiving and Christmas with Thanksgiving baskets. Like last year, we did gift cards at Thanksgiving and Christmas, along with food baskets and toys and turkeys. All that is part of our outreach. The average Catholic church spends 5% on outreach. We choose to spend 34%. So we like triple tithe, in a sense, as a St. Martin's church to those in need around our community. So I just invite each of you to kind of ask yourself, what is it I give to God's community, and how can I share my resources to be able to continue to let us be a blessing to others? God has blessed each of us in very special ways. May we choose to share our blessings with others, those in need, and those here in our community. As God blesses us, may we give to God, to give God thanks and praise for all of our blessings. Amen. I invite you to pray with me our creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate in the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us lift up to the Lord our needs. For peace in the Middle East and Ukraine, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace on the streets of Washington, D.C., let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may continue to be good stewards of our time, talent, and treasure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
I invite you to lift up your own needs and concerns. Lord God, we lift up to you these and all those needs that weigh at our hearts. We make them known in confidence through your Son, Jesus, who lives with and through us now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
As we prepare our altar again, thank all of you who continue to support our ministries here at St. Martin's. It's your generosity that allows us to be generous to others in need in your name. Lord God, we ask that you bless this bread and this wine, fruit of the field and fruit of the vine, to become for us the body and blood of Jesus. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my friends, that my sacrifice and yours become acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, and the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Grant us, Lord, we pray, a sincere respect for your many gifts, that through the action of your grace, we may be strengthened to share your gifts in building your kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And I'm with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world, arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set us over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all that you've made. And forever praise you in your mighty works through your Son, Jesus. We join all the angels as we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit, that they become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it, gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and eat. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. And let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Wilton, our Bishop, and all of the women and men who lead and guide the church. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the Blessed Apostles, Martin, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him. O God, almighty Father, the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray in the words that Jesus gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
And for those who are blessed with have so folks around you, I invite you to share a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
I invite you to spiritually ask the Lord to give you that grace and strength and wisdom to share all the gifts that God gives to you with those around. This is the body of Christ.
There is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. Sometimes I feel discouraged, and think my works in vain. But then the Holy Spirit revives my soul again. Oh, there is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. Oh, there is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. If you cannot preach like Peter, if you cannot pray like Paul, you can tell the love of Jesus and say he died for all. Oh, there is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul. There is a balm in Gilead to make the wounded whole. There is a balm in Gilead to heal the sin-sick soul.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from our participation in these heavenly things, we may be strengthened to share our gifts to build your kingdom through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I invite you to pray with us our family prayer for justice and human dignity, crafted by the Archdiocese of Washington. Loving and faithful God, we come to you, Father, to ask that through your Son, Jesus, and a communion with the Holy Spirit, you help us in the battle against the miracles of original sin of racism that divides us from being the body of Christ that we are called to be as your children. We implore you to give us your wisdom so that we may build a community founded on the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people, from the womb to the tomb, and to live in communion like the divine communion of the Holy Trinity. Bless parents that may form their children in faith to love one another, regardless of skin color, ethnicity, and national origin, just as Jesus loves us. Bless and protect all of us as we live out our faith in being instruments of your peace, as St. Francis said. Fill us with the thirst for justice and righteousness. Hear our prayer and give us the courage, compassion, and perseverance to root out any form of injustice within our communities and to bring the healing love of Christ to all in need. Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of our Church, hasten to help us and intercede on our behalf so that our diocese can continue to witness to the gospel message of the life and dignity of all people. Amen. Our announcements. This coming Wednesday, October 25th, we'll stuff envelopes for our Christmas concert, so they'll start at 12 noon down in the Pioneer Room. Last time, they were finished by about 6 o'clock in the evening. So look ahead. The concert is the first Sunday in December, December the 3rd at 5 p.m., and we'll have that. We'll live stream it. We'll also put it on YouTube, so we'll have all kind of options. Or you can come in person. Teen confirmation classes begin the first Sunday in November, November the 5th, after the 12 noon Mass. Starting next week, we'll begin collecting non-perishable food for our Thanksgiving drive. So, you know, I actually heard this when I was at the Mass in Hawaii. The pastor said, very seriously, I want you to know I check all the food coming in. We want you to give us your best, not the junk you have left over in the back of your pantry. I thought, you know what? That's a great line. So, if you know of anyone in your family or you wish to become fully Catholic through confirmation, baptism, you want to receive First Communion finally, you know, you contact us. We have a process for all that stuff. See, I don't know nobody birthdays. I've been gone for a while, but if it's someone's birthday, have a blessed and happy birthday. I definitely had a blessed and happy birthday hanging out there. So I can't believe I'm 75 and still working. I'm still halfway sane most days. So God is good. That's all I can say. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the Lord continue to strengthen us to share God's blessing with those around us. Let the church say.
Amen. Amen.
May the Lord give blessing in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
As you go,
as you go.